Derrick James, man, you know, that's it's good people, man. He said, you know, I riled him up and I got him going. And you know, the second time around, they gonna kick my ass. You know what I mean? So you know, I don't expect nothing less from Derrick. You know, it's all good. You know, it's all fun of the nature of competitiveness, and I love it.
Any words exchanged between you and Charlo since the fight? Jermell Charlo.
You know what? We don't even know he's alive right now. You know what I mean? Like, he hasn't made a post. I've been looking on him to see if he made a post. You know, he haven't even made a post yet. But you know, for me, it kind of shows the hunger back in him, because it shows, fuck the bullshit, fuck all the games of being a champion, stop all the tour, stop all the going here, going there, and lock in. Each and every time, when you're a champion, you gotta lock in. You know what I mean? So it shows me that he's locking in, like he's mentally, he gets it. You know what I mean? He gets it. You know, it's not, you know, when you're the champion, we everybody's gunning for you. And I was one of those guys gunning for him. You know what I mean? So he broke camp to go to a herd fight that didn't matter at the moment. You know what I mean? So everything that he was doing was just, I feel like I was unfocused, you know what I mean? And I feel like now he's locking in, and you know, lock in, because I'm about to lock in a minute again.
So those personal moments he was doing was silently motivating him. Those personal moments in terms of non-boxing personal moments was motivating you.
Man, that shit super motivated me. You know what I mean? Like I said, I already was confident in myself, but when I start seeing them going to herds, and I start seeing Floyd around him, and I said, oh, I know for sure, 100%. I was already 100%. I went up to 169%. 169% for sure. I'm going to beat this guy, because while he was out there with hurting them, after the hurting the fight, I got right back in the gym. You know, that night I was in the gym. You know what I mean? So like I said, my mental to become a champion was super high, and now my mental to keep the belt is going to be even higher.
Tony, what do you think about performance enhancers in the sport? Do you think it's still a problem?
I think it's always fighters looking for another way out instead of just putting the work in. You know what I mean? That's life for you, though. It's life. Everybody looks for the easy way out. So it's all, you know, it's not going to stop now, and it's not going to stop later.
What should be the punishment?
Thank you. And
part two, like I just interviewed Victor Conte. Should guys like him be readmitted back into dealing with fighting?
Shout out to Vic, man. He the best nigga to do. He the GOAT.
Victor who?
Vic.
Why? Why is he the GOAT?
He the GOAT.
He's the GOAT or the GOAT?
He's the GOAT.
Explain.
He's the GOAT.
Explain.
Man, Victor Conte been doing this shit since I was a kid.
Uh-huh.
You know, he's the GOAT, man. He's always been good at what he does. You know what I mean? And I don't know the logistics behind him and nothing like that, but you know.
He was popped. He did go to jail for illegal for
PEDs. He's been the GOAT, and he come back. He's been the GOAT.
He went to 4-5. That's what he's doing.
4-3. What the fuck you talking about 4-5?
Mike, man. With a 4-5, you know.
Yeah, you know, so.
Why don't you get him on the team then?
Huh?
Why don't you get Vic on the team?
Nah, I'm straight. You know, my circle is tight. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, if I can't do it myself, if I can do it with the team I'm with, then I shouldn't be in the sport. You know, I just won a world championship with the same circle I've been with since I was 5 years old. So, you know, for me, I don't need nobody. I don't need nothing new. No extra vitamins.